Now come to the topic rings.
So far we have studied groups.
Group is an algebraic structure with one binary operation. But in a ring, it is also an algebraic structure, but it is equipped with two binary operations. Let us see its definition. Ring. Suppose R is a non-empty set equipped with two binary operations, plus and dot. They are called addition and multiplication, and they are denoted by plus and dot, respectively. That is, for all AB in R, we have A plus B belongs to R, and A into B belongs to R. It means R is closed with respect to addition, and R is closed with respect to multiplication. Then this algebraic structure, R plus dot, is called a ring if the following postulates are satisfied. We call R plus dot a ring if the following conditions given here are satisfied. First four conditions are related with plus, this plus binary operation. Addition is associative. Associative, that is A plus B in a bracket plus C is equal to A plus B plus C for all ABC in R. First. Second, addition is commutative. That is A plus B is equal to B plus A for all AB in R. Third, there exists an element denoted by 0 in R such that 0 plus A is equal to 0A for all A in R. And fourth, to each element A in R, there exists an element minus A in R such that minus A plus A is equal to 0. For these four postulates, R plus is abelian because these are conditions for abelian group. R is closed with respect to plus. Associative, commutative, this is our identity element, this is our inverse. So R plus is abelian. Next, fifth condition, multiplication is associative. That is A dot B dot C is equal to A dot B dot C for all ABC in R. Sixth, multiplication is distributive with respect to addition. That is for all ABC in R, A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. This is called left distributive law. And B plus C dot A is equal to B dot A plus C dot A. This is called right distributive law. Now, since addition is commutative in R, we shall have 0 belongs to R such that 0 plus A is equal to A. This is equal to A plus 0 for all A in R. Also, if A belongs to R, then minus A plus A is equal to 0, which is equal to A plus minus A. Thus, R will be an abelian group with respect to addition. The element 0 in R will be the additive identity. It is called the 0 element of the ring. Since in a group, the identity element is unique, therefore, everything possesses a unique 0 element, and it will be the identity element for addition composition. We shall always denote this element by the symbol 0. So identity element is denoted by this symbol 0. This is 0, identity element. This is not the number 0. This is symbol 0. So students should not confuse it with the number 0. Okay. Next, we shall define A minus B is equal to A plus minus B. The equation A plus X is equal to B will have a unique solution in R, and it will be X is equal to B minus A. Let us check it. Obviously, A plus B minus A means A plus X is equal to A plus B plus minus A. It is equal to A plus minus A plus B. Since addition is associative, this is equal to A plus minus A plus B. This is equal to minus A plus B. This is 0 plus B. So it is B. So this is solution of this is B. A plus X is equal to B. Similarly, solution of Y plus A is B. You can solve it also. Both the cancellation laws hold good for addition in R, that is for all ABC in R. A plus B is equal to A plus C. Left cancellation law, apply left cancellation law, implies B is equal to C. And B plus A is equal to C plus A implies B is equal to C. Here apply right cancellation law. From right cancellation law, both A will cancel each other. If in a ring we have A plus B is equal to 0, then A is equal to minus B and B is equal to minus A. Next, the concept of ring with unity. If in a ring R, there exists an element denoted by 1, such that 1 into A is equal to A, this is A into 1 for all A in R, then R will be called a ring with unity element.
unity. This one is called unity element. Since 1 into a is equal to a, this is equal to a into 1. The element 1 in R is called the unity element of the ring. Obviously, this one is the multiplicative identity of R. Multiplicative identity, because if you multiply any element with 1, you get the same element. Thus, if a ring possesses multiplicative identity, then it is a ring with unity. Then we call this ring a ring with unity. Next concept, commutative ring. If in a ring R, the multiplication composition is also commutative. That is, if we have A into B is equal to B into A for all A in R, for all AB in R, then R is called a commutative ring. So for a commutative ring, A into B should be equal to B into A. In future, we will not write A dot B, we simply write AB. AB means A into B. Next, let us see some elementary properties of a ring. Theorem. If R is a ring, then for all A, B, C in R, first, A into 0 equal to 0 into A is equal to 0. A into minus B equal to minus AB is equal to minus A into B. Minus A into minus B is equal to AB. A into B minus C is equal to AB minus AC. B minus C into A is equal to BA minus CA. Let us see first one. Proof. A into 0 can be written as A into 0 plus 0. It is equal to, since 0 plus 0 is 0, this is equal to A into 0 plus A into 0. So by left distributive law, let us come to our next page. So add here 0 plus A into 0 is equal to A into 0 plus 0. Since we can add 0 in A into 0, no difference. Now R is a group with respect to addition. Therefore, applying right cancellation law. Now applied here right cancellation law. So this A into 0 and this A into 0, both will go cancel each other. Therefore, we get 0 is equal to A into 0. Similarly, we have 0A is equal to 0 plus 0A. This is equal to 0A plus 0A. Add here 0. 0 plus 0 is equal to 0A plus 0A. Now apply right cancellation law. Then again, we get 0 is equal to 0 into A. So first part is proved. Next, see the second part. A into minus B plus B is equal to A into 0. It implies that A into minus B plus AB equal to 0. It implies that A into minus B is equal to minus AB. It implies that minus A, similarly, we have minus A plus A into B is equal to 0 into B, or minus AB plus AB is equal to 0 implies minus A into B is equal to minus AB. Second part is also proved. Now third, we have minus A into minus B is equal to minus times minus AB. Since A into minus B is equal to minus AB, this can be written as minus minus AB, since minus A into B is equal to minus AB. It is equal to AB, since minus will be your plus. Since R is a group with respect to addition, and in a group we have minus times minus A is equal to A. Next, fourth, we have A into B minus C is equal to A into B plus minus C. This is equal to A into B plus A into minus C. Left distributive law. This is equal to A into B plus minus times AC. Since A into minus C is equal to minus AC, so it is equal to AB into AC. Now this fourth part is also proved. Next, fifth part, B minus C into A is equal to B plus minus C into A. This can be written as BA plus minus C into A. So this is equal to BA plus minus CA. It means it is BA minus CA. It is also proved. Next, see one more concept. Integral multiples of the elements of a ring. Suppose R is a ring and A belongs to R. If M is a positive integer, then we define M into A is equal to A plus A plus A plus A up to M times. Because suppose 3 into A means A plus A plus A 3 times. 4 into A means A plus A plus A plus A 4 times. Also, we define 0 into A is equal to 0. Here, 0 on the left hand side is the integer 0, and 0 on the right hand side is the 0 element. See here, in 0 into A, this 0 is the integer 0, but this 0 is the 0 element of the ring. Means it is additive identity of the ring. Both look same, but their definitions are different. If M is a positive integer, then minus M will be a negative integer. We define minus M into A is equal to minus times MA. It is equal to minus A plus A up to M terms. It is equal to minus A plus minus A plus minus up to M terms. So it is equal to M into minus A. If M and N are integers, we can prove that MA plus NA is equal to M plus N into A. This is equal to M into NA. This is equal to MNA. And MA into NA is equal to MN into A square. Also, we can prove that M into A plus B is equal to MA plus MB for all AB in R.
Next, the students should not confuse that this is the distributive law we assumed in the postulate for ring. It is not so. Here M is an integer and AB are elements of R. Next, we have some examples. Example 1, examples of example 1, example 2, and example 3, example 4, example 5, example 6. Some of the examples I will solve for you. No need to worry. First, you write all of them, and you have or you feel any difficulty, ask me your questions here. I will try to solve them. This is your another topic, rings, groups. About group, we have studied earlier, group, subgroup, some theorems and examples we have studied earlier. But now you see here the concepts of ring. Note this very important point that a group is an algebraic structure with just one binary operation. But a ring is an algebraic structure equipped with two binary operations. These are two basic differences between group and ring. So note down them